Ryzen AI 300 is here, and we get our first look at AMD's latest mobile platform with the ASUS ZenBook 16S. It is a crazy thin and light laptop that is neither thin nor light on features. Will this laptop guide us towards Zen 5's vision of mobile nirvana? Well, we're about to find out right here, right now on Robitech. It really is an exciting world for laptops, especially as we look at the number of AI-focused devices powered by Intel, Qualcomm, AMD, and even Apple. That being said, I have been so excited to get my hands on this laptop. Not only is this our first time testing AMD's new Zen 5 platform, but the way we're getting to see it is a marvel of engineering. But because of that, we have a bit of a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde situation where we have a new laptop to review and a new architecture to talk about. In other words, we can't really talk about them apart from each other. So much like our first look at Meteor Lake last year, this is going to be a bit more of an evolving story as we see more and more devices and get more time with Ryzen AI 300. Also, we only had like a week with this laptop because of when we received the laptop from AMD. So if you want us to know more or you want to know more in depth about the experience using this laptop, you guys got to let us know in the comments below. It's you who decide whether we do another one or not. Okay, so now onto the star of the show. This is the ASUS ZenBook S16. It's a thin and light laptop geared towards productivity, students, and the business on the go crowds. So it's a bit of a jack of multiple trades kind of laptop with some unexpected masteries for a thin and light. Measuring it at 13.92 inches or 354 millimeters wide, 9.57 inches or 243 millimeters deep, and 0.51 inches or 11.9 millimeters tall, and a weight of 3.31 pounds or 1.5 kilograms, the ZenBook S16 is probably the thinnest and lightest laptop we have seen to date. It's thinner than the ROG Zephyrus G16 0.59 inches or 14.9 millimeters, and lighter than its 4.3 pounds or 1.95 kilograms. So yeah, it definitely fits the bill of thin and light. And the chassis on this thing is actually really interesting because ASUS is calling the material Ceraluminum. This is a high-tech ceramic material that's used in things like luxury watches and the aerospace industry. Basically, it's super lightweight and durable, and it's super resistant to fingerprints too. As for the cost, the model we're looking at here has an MSRP of $1,699.99 at the time of this video, which is incredible when you start looking at like what's inside of this thing. Starting with the CPU, our version of the ZenBook S16 has AMD's new Ryzen AI9 HX370 processor. We're gonna throw the details up on the screen while we talk about this, so feel free to pause as needed. Now, you may note that the Ryzen AI9 HX370 has two different types of cores, Zen 5 and Zen 5C cores. You can think of these like Intel's P cores and E cores at a very, very, very high level. The Zen 5 cores are gonna be more like your performant cores, while the Zen 5C cores are gonna be more for your lower powered tasks. Now, in the case you've been probably thinking and shouting at the screen, Roby, did AMD just copy Intel's homework with these two different core types? Not really. More like what AMD is doing is different from their architecture standpoint, but again, we can see why people might think they are similar. We do have a whole video on how Zen 5 works, which you can check out right here. Go watch our video, and hey, while you're there, if you could go ahead and like and subscribe to the channel, that would be absolutely amazing. Okay, now let's get back to the ZenBook S16. For GPU, our ZenBook uses AMD's Radeon 890M, which is an integrated GPU based off what AMD is calling RDNA 3.5. So it's kind of like the architecture of the Radeon 7000 series GPUs, but with some more advanced tuning. The GPU is driving a 16-inch 2880 by 1800 OLED display that ASUS calls their Lumia display. Now, just to point out some marketing here, ASUS is calling this a 3K display, but we've seen the same resolution on the HP Omen Transcend 14, and they're calling it 2.8K. Let's call it what it is, 1800p. It's slightly bigger than 1440p, but it's not quite 4K. Anyway, the ZenBook Lumia display has a 120 Hz refresh rate, 0.2 millisecond response time, and a color gamut that covers 100% of the DCI-P3 color spectrum. Oh, and it's a touch display. ASUS even included a stylus with the ZenBook S16, and this isn't a gimmick here. The screen and the stylus are both nice and responsive, so this combination of touchscreen, stylus, and color accuracy really makes this thing appealing to graphic artists. Now, before we get too far out from talking about the Ryzen AI processor, we do have to talk about the AI part of the name. AMD has integrated their XTNA2 Neural Processing Unit, or NPU, into Ryzen AI processors. According to AMD, this NPU is capable of 50 trillion operations per second, or TOPS, which more than meets Microsoft's standard for the Copilot Plus ready PCs, and why we have a Copilot button right there. Listen, I know not everybody is excited about AI, but AMD is making sure that their Ryzen AI devices are ready for whatever is getting implemented, whether that's inside of Windows, whether games start rolling out with more AI features, any of the agentization, which is expected to happen of AI, this thing is apparently gonna be able to handle any of that stuff. Moving on to system memory, the ZenBook S16 that we have in front of us comes with 32 gigs of LPDDR5X RAM. The RAM is soldered onto the motherboard, which makes it fast, but the trade-off is that you won't be upgrading the RAM. And I actually don't think that so far, and the editors could prove me wrong, there isn't a thin and light, like a true thin and light, that hasn't had soldered on RAM that you could upgrade quite yet. Now this is super important because the CPU, GPU, and MPU are going to need to share RAM. So having more RAM at a faster speed is ideal. We saw Asus do this with the new ROG Ally X2. And if you want to know more about that, you can check out our video on that right here. Now moving on to storage, the ZenBook S16 comes with a 1 TB NVMe Gen 4 SSD. Now being a thin and light laptop, connectivity is a little thinner on the ZenBook. Now we're going to throw up a list of ports right here on the screen so we can make any comments on it. But again, pause is needed so you don't miss anything. Now the ZenBook has 3 USB ports, but only one of them is a USB Type-A port. While there is no built-in Ethernet port, Asus does throw in a USB-A to Ethernet connector, which is cool, but not as cool if you needed to plug in a USB Type-A thumb drive while hardwired onto a network. Now, the other thing here is that it is using USB-C for charging. So you might need to do a bit of port juggling if you need to connect a bunch of devices to the ZenBook. But to be fair, you're probably gonna need a portable hub with most thin and light laptops anyway. It's part of the price you pay for a laptop this thin and this light. So up to you if it's worth it or not. Now, in case you missed it, the ZenBook S16 has Wi-Fi 7. Now, I know we've been on Asus's case about this with the Strix G16 and the Zephyrus G16, but hey, here it is. And so gold star, Asus. I mean, it's awesome, and multi-leak operation can change your world. Now, while the speakers in this may not be Zephyrus level of awesome, the speakers on the ZenBook are pretty good. They're a little bit flat, but not bad for a movie night in a hotel or for anything that you might be consuming around the office. Now, moving on to the keyboard, the ZenBook S16 has a backlit keyboard with chiclet keys. Honestly, it's not my favorite. The keys are a bit too mushy, but if you're used to the keyboard on like an old MacBook, they're probably gonna feel very familiar. I think the thing is it just, it's almost like typing on air and there's not enough haptics, but I mean, it is accurate. And I think what Connor got to, like, what, 120 words per minute. So it's more than capable. Now, as for the touchpad, this thing is massive. Asus says that it's 40% larger than their last ZenBook touchpad, but it does have some smart features actually built into it. On the left side of the touchpad, you can either swipe up or down to raise or lower system volume, and on the right side, you can actually adjust screen brightness. We did have a few times where we accidentally used these gestures, so just be aware, it can be a little bit sensitive. But I mean, Brian, you were actually like, hey, I'd love to actually see that as a feature on other laptops. As for power, this laptop has a 78 watt hour battery and a 65 watt power supply that charges via USB-C. The power brick is very similar in size as the one that comes with the Asus ROG Ally X, so it's definitely designed for travel. As for battery life, we got an average of 12 hours and 42 minutes out of the ZenBook S16. This is very comparable to the Core Ultra 7 based MSI Prestige 16 AI Evo at 12 hours and 7 minutes, but not quite the nearly 23 and a half hours we got out of the Snapdragon X Elite Surface laptop. Still, 12, nearly 13 hours on a battery is not too shabby. And keep in mind, these numbers are gathered using UIProcyon's Office Productivity Battery Life Benchmark. Okay, now for the part that I know you're looking for, the gaming benchmarks. Well, some of you, there's probably some office guys who are like, gaming, but here it is. Now, the information is going to look a lot different than our typical laptop reviews, since we're trying to collect data across AMD, Intel, Qualcomm, and Apple landscapes for a more comparative picture. Now, we still have some gaps, so you're not gonna see all of our data just yet. We're also testing games and at a lower common denominator when it comes to screen resolution. We'll slap the details on screen so you can see exact settings we were using when we were doing our testing. Okay, starting with 3D Mark's Wildlife Extreme benchmark, this benchmark is designed to test performance in notebooks, tablets, and smartphones that have a single integrated GPU. In Wildlife Extreme, the ZenBook got a score of 6296 with frames per second averaging at around 38 frames. Again, this is a metric that will work across platforms, but what about AAA titles that you can actually play on your ZenBook? Well, in Shadow of the Tomb Raider, the ZenBook ran an average of 64 frames per second. Next up, Borderlands 3 averaged just shy of 56 frames per second. And finally, in Total War Warhammer 3, we have 3 different benchmark results. In the battle benchmark, the ZenBook ran at an average of 124 frames per second. In the campaign benchmark, we saw averages of around 119, and finally in the Skaven benchmark, the ZenBook averaged a bit over 75 frames per second. Overall, the mobile Radeon 890M put on a good show at a lower resolution. Now remember, this is just running on an integrated GPU here. You do have to think of this along the lines of devices like the ROG Ally more than the Zephyrus G16, which we'll get an AMD version of very soon, which is very excited about. In other words, the ZenBook S16 is going to be the laptop for people like that junior executive that just got done with a full day of travel and meeting, then takes off a suit and coat or blazer and hops into some Rocket League to blow off some steam. Now, I want that to kind of sink in for a second, because this used to be unthinkable with thin and light laptops, especially things that were this thin and this light. And just to ensure that this isn't conjecture here, while we were getting ready to film this video, I had two other members of the Robitech team, Brian and Connor, take some time with the ZenBook S16 to see what the gaming experience was like. Here was their take. Now, while playing Rocket League, the guys thought that the ZenBook did a pretty good job of handling the gaming experience. One thing they both pointed out, though, is that even though the system was firing on all cylinders, which gaming is stressful, the fans never got overpoweringly noisy, and the laptop was not hot to the touch at all. These are both really good things to note. Now, they also tried to play Cyberpunk 2077 with some mixed result. While the ZenBook could run Cyberpunk close to 30 frames per second, and they had the benchmark running smoothly in like the 30s and 40s, the actual experience while gaming was a bit on the stuttery side. Basically, here's the breakdown of what we thought of the gameplay experience. The ZenBook is capable of running AAA games, but not at a level you're gonna wanna be gaming at. Now, you could spend time tweaking and experimenting with settings, but really, indie games are where it's gonna be at on the ZenBook. Games like Civilization, Hades, Dredge, Dave the Diver, those are your kind of games. And honestly, this is still a step above where enterprise or thin and light laptops have been in the past. So let's talk about productivity, which, I mean, there's now a whole another group of people who are like up on the edge of their seat. Okay, I'm ready. Will this thing PowerPoint like a boss? How many decks per week can I make? Okay, now we used UL Procyon's Office Productivity Benchmark to look at the ZenBook S16 in comparison to the MSI Prestige 16 AI Evo and the new Microsoft Surface laptop, the one that was powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon. As it turns out, they each had their strengths. For the ZenBook, it was great with Word, the Prestige took the lead on PowerPoint and Outlook, leaving the Surface to excel at Excel. To be fair, they all did really well here, operating on an average within 5% of each other. So it ended up being like that Spider-Man meme where they're all pointing at each other instead of the big blowout in favor of one versus the other. As for acoustic performance throughout the test, the ZenBook kept its calm even when under load. When we look at the numbers, we recorded the ZenBook 16S running at 43.6 decibels while idle and 52 under load. For comparison, these decibel levels range from gentle hum of a refrigerator to the sound of rainfall. Not bad, but now I'm calm and I kind of want a snack. All right, with all of this in mind, what did we learn about the Ryzen AI 9 HX370 and the ZenBook S16? Well, we learned that Asus really knows how to make a thin and light laptop because, wow, does this thing ever fit that description? Again, I cannot stress how incredibly well-engineered this thing is. Seriously, if your main priority is finding a laptop that weighs next to nothing, the ZenBook 16S does that and looks so dang sexy while doing it. But don't take its lightweight for it being a lightweight when it comes to the competitive landscape. Ryzen AI seems to have a leg up on the competition when it comes to gaming and anything to do with heavier CPU-based rendering processes. In tests like Cinebench and Blender, as well as our gaming benchmarks, the Ryzen AI 9 HX370 ran away with the win here. This is great news for the person who needs a thin and light laptop that can pull out some extra power on the go. Even with what the guys experience, I'm still impressed enough on the gaming front that I think this could be a good option for indies on the go, even if AAA gaming itself still seems to be limited. Remember that this was something unthinkable on laptops in the past. To be clear, this isn't gonna replace laptops with a discrete GPU or be at like a 14900HX level of processing power, but it's going to provide a lot of performance at a low power draw. On that note, when we looked at the power draw under full CPU load, the Ryzen AI 9 HX370 was very conservative in its power consumption at an average of just under 33 watts. For comparison, that figure is in line with the Prestige Core Ultra 7155H at 35 watts. Now, from a user experience standpoint and what we really think about Ryzen AI, we're gonna really need more time with the platform to fully discover its quirks and the things we like about it. And don't worry, we got lots of laptops coming, so we'll definitely figure that out. So please, Don't tune this part out or mishear me. What we're about to share are our first impressions, and so far, there is a lot to be excited about here. Now, the biggest question we have is with the XDNA 2 MPU. We know that on paper, it's supposed to be killer at AI tasks, super efficient and accurate, but when we try to look at the comparative data, it looked like AMD, Qualcomm, and Intel are doing the math for their AI tasks all a bit differently. And we just weren't able to be confident enough with our findings to put any data out here that says, hey, this is better at AI than anything else. So where does that leave us with our bottom line recommendation? As far as the ZenBook 16S goes, it is a beautiful laptop with exceptional battery life for remote tasks. Just understand that there are some costs associated with thin and light laptops, like sacrificing some ports. But that is really a small price to pay when you consider that this thing is crazy thin and light and is stunningly beautiful without all the fingerprint stuff, a beautiful screen. It's just a really excellent travel companion, and it won't break your back when you're carrying it around. If you're the type of person that needs all day battery life on laptop for productivity tasks, graphic design, and playing indie games, we think the ZenBook S16 will serve you very well. I just have to stress this one more time. It's a really exciting time for laptop buyers, and with a new platform like Ryzen AI 300, there's a lot to be excited about. These are our impressions of the 2024 ASUS ZenBook S16 and our first look at AMD's Ryzen AI 9 mobile processors. But we want to know what you think. Let us know down in the comments below. Do you like the form factor? Do you feel like thin and light is worth some of the sacrifices? And what do you think about the gaming potential of something like this? Or is that just something you don't care about? Let us know again down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring the notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robitech. Also, if you have questions about laptops or you just want a further discussion about tech, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robitech. Amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about these very subjects. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us on all the socials at Robitech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video. We look forward to seeing you on the next one.